Sports. It's in the game.
Takes to make a video game like the very successful Madden franchise, specifically Madden NFL 07. Joined right now by the executive producer of EA Sports NFL Football, Dale Jackson, and the lead producer, David Ortiz. Guys, how much of a labor of love is this for you guys, first of all, to do this game every year of Madden NFL?
It's a huge labor of love. We're the biggest competitors in the world, so being able to make a game where we can go out and try to better ourselves every year and be the best game on the market is something that we eat up and love to come to work every day.
Same thing with you, David?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we're excited to work on a game that, you know, not just fans across the world play, but all of our friends play as well. So the scrutiny's there every year. People want to see the best things from us, and we can't hide from the criticism.
Right. It's going to be in every home. There's no question about that. It's the most highly anticipated game launch every year. So what do we have in store for folks in Madden NFL 07 this year that's different and new from years past?
The level of detail and authenticity we've been able to achieve in the game this year is unmatched in just about any game, not just sports games, but any game across the board. So the level of immersion and reality in football is better than ever before. That coupled with the running game that we've added this year with the unique running back styles, lead blocking control, it's going to be a huge year for this year.
Is it almost difficult now? Because it seems like every year you're adding more things and the game becomes more successful. It's almost like, hey, that's great, but then we got to do this again next year.
Now that the platforms are getting stronger and stronger, all we limit is time. And how much can we actually get in before the game comes out? We have no limit to ideas. The NFL is our resource and our reference point to look at what they do. Every year the NFL evolves. There's rule changes. There's new players. There's new personalities. And as that happens, we have more material to then try to build and bring back into the game to give our fans that NFL fantasy.
And that's exactly what they're looking for every time, to take it one step further as they continue to build. And Madden NFL 07 continues to take that step to the next level. Listen, we'll take you through how the game is played, some of the new features, and everything you need to know that's new and different about Madden NFL 07 as we go through and give you a behind-the-scenes look at what's different in this game and how the game is put together. Trey Wingo here with you as we continue to go inside Madden NFL 07, the way to play the game, and how this game is different from years past. Joined now by three people who are going to help us discuss play styles and how exactly to get the most out of your Madden experience. What are your nicknames? This is D-Cass, that's D-Train, and this is just Ryan, ladies and gentlemen. No hard W. You like that? That works for you?
That'll work.
Fair enough. Everybody gets a full nickname. We need to talk about that. All right, if I want to be the best Madden player ever, what are the play styles I would go up against?
I think the play styles that you basically see when you play Madden are guys that like to run the ball all the time, guys that like to hit the ball out, and then you got the people that play more of a balanced, leveled off game.
Yeah, you definitely count that. I consider myself to be more of a balanced player, ball control, that type of thing. You have guys that just want to try to stay away from actually playing a realistic game. You have guys want to pound the ball all the time, and like you said, air it out. So.
What I've experienced mostly is fast quarterbacks like Duke. Dante Culpepper. And with all the new quarterbacks coming in, you know, we're going to face a lot of quarterback scrimmage. So, you know, that's probably one of the most predominant.
All right, let's stick with the quarterbacks here for a minute. Let's say you're playing against somebody who basically is Mike Martz gone wild. All he's going to do is throw the ball 743 times a game. How in Madden can you try and stop that?
Well, it can be tough to stop that. You just have to be sure you have the right personnel. That's the first key. If they're in a pass offense, you have to come out in a pass defense. You have to make sure that you have your good cornerbacks and their good receivers, and you need to just basically call coverage.
I was going to say, just make sure you have the right guys in the right places, basically. I mean, make sure you have speed on speed, and just about it.
Yeah, if you get any kind of coaching on your opponent or anything like that, you might want to have some audible set, you know, so you can switch on the fly. You know, do some quick coaching decisions on the fly.
Okay, so that's what you do against someone who likes to throw the ball a lot. What do you do if you line another guy who's basically like the Steelers in the second half of the football game? Hand off right.
I would say the same principles apply. You just have to have these big, tough guys in there. You need a lot of linebackers on the field, and you need to make sure that you have your guys who can stop the run, who can blow up the offensive line, who can get some penetration.
Yeah, I like to definitely put guys in that situation. You know, make sure you get your D-line splits right. You know, make sure you have guys concise and down.
make sure you're blitzing at the right time, you know, use a lot of press coverage and things like that to make sure you at least get the guys in the right place.
Yeah, if you're playing against someone who's going to pound you out, you probably want to lose 4-3, 4-3-0, defense like that. I probably would lose 3-9, 4-3, so yeah, I probably use a 4-3 defense on that game.
Just find the Ted Washington guy and stick him in the middle. Hey, basically, as you're going, how do you elevate your game when you start playing competitive?
Well, I think when you start playing competitively, you get a little bit out of your comfort zone because you have plays that you run, you have things you like to do, and competitive players will stop what you're good at doing. So that gives you the opportunity to expand your game, to learn new things, and to add your arsenal. That's when you become really good.
Yeah, it's kind of like the coach when he scripts his first few plays, and once you realize, wait, these don't work anymore, then you have to go back and revisit all your strategies.
Yeah. They good players are going to force you to create new, different ways of playing, so... You know, I think the more people that you see, you know, by playing online, going to different tournaments, you know, just playing anybody that you can.
A lot of people start out and they're just, you know, all they know how to do is like one type of thing. And once you play more people, I mean, by the end, you can play with any team, any play style, and you can hang with anyone. And that's kind of the most important thing.
All right, let's take this to the next level then, because basically that's automatic strategy. Let's talk adjustments. Okay, that seems sort of what we're talking about here. Once you get out of the huddle, what sort of adjustments can you make before the ball snapped?
I personally think that half the game is won or lost before you even hike the ball when you're on your way up to the line. You have to know, you have to see the defense, you have to see, if you're on defense, you have to see the offense. You have to try to get in your opponent's head and figure out what they're doing and use all the different kinds of adjustments that we give you to your advantage.
Yeah, I mean, Madden provides a huge suite of pre-play controls, and I think I agree with DCAS, but that's the most important part of the game is really getting your guys in the right places. And sounds kind of like a broken record, but that's like the most important thing is make sure you have the right people and the right personnel on the field at the right time and the right place.
Something that pre-snap read, basically.
Exactly. Something that people don't know is that you have to pay attention when you're playing the game. You have to pay attention to what you're doing. You also have to pay attention to what you might think your opponent might be doing. As in the play call screen, you know, you can call a fake play. You know, so I can make you think that I'm calling one thing and I'm calling something else. You know, and then when I get to the huddle, I may be seen as on high, I'm seen as going on a hot line, and I'm really not doing anything. I'm just making screens up and down. You know, you don't know what I mean.
So it sounds a lot like Colts do every 3 seconds at the last scrimmage in a game, and that leads us to the next question. What about audible? Because that's something that Colts do very well in the actual NFL. When do you audible in that?
I think that you audible all the time to take a chance to keep your opponent off balance. It's like exactly what you're talking about with the Colts. I mean, if you come out and you see a certain look and you have a play right there at your fingertips that counters that defensive look, you should call it and you should run it. It's a great way to keep your opponent off balance and keep them guessing, and that's just the mental game.
Yeah, the one thing I like to do is try to keep all my audibles in the same formation. So I can call a formation, come out, and charge them out and do that formation. So that way, the person I'm playing has no idea what I'm going to run. You know, I can come out and run in the same single back formation. I can audible, and I have all my audibles set in that same formation. And people have no idea. There's no tip. They don't know what I'm going to do. So.
Now, what I use the audible for, I may want to run a particular play. I see you in the defense that has been stopping me a little bit. I'll audible to something else. You'll come out of what you set up, and I'll audible right back to what I wanted to run originally. You know, just to get you out of what you're doing.
Because you're that kind of guy.
Right.
That's what you'll do.
I'm all that.
Yeah. Well, I think we've all said that was that already. Okay. We've gone through play styles here with Easter. We're going to go back and talk to them more about execution during a game and a tournament, the things you might face in Madden NFL 7.